need a cable. We just need, hold up, it's done. Defuel, cable. Whoa. This other stuff, right? I don't want to start doing naked runs and shit. I'd rather get gear and then go in with some relatively geared runs. I should have just left. I was trying to get in there. I was hoping someone would kill him. Sir PJ, thanks for the follow. How you going? Going good? It's rough, dude. It's really fucking rough. We are level 16, got a few hideout upgrades done. Challenges aren't going very well, to be honest. It's fucking rough. How are you going? Yeah, you're on like the last kind of 10 to 15 tasks and you just don't have the motivation to do them. I know what you mean. At the end of the day, my first wipe, I kind of just played the game how I wanted to play it. Kind of just found out how to play it, essentially. And then second wipe, you can really kind of go for Kappa and really sweat it if you have time. That's how I found it anyway, but. Just play the game how you enjoy it, I guess. If you're enjoying just messing around, that's the best way to play. see, I'm really bad. Hopefully find some heals. Thanks for hanging out, dude. Some heals from this one. Oh, yes. Hit the stash and then head into the village. Wonder if that scab bled out. Point in looting without a root. So just take jackets. Yeah, it's always raining, dude. They turned it down, but it's still so loud. It's raining all the time. Is that the scav spawn? Yeah. The rain is awful. If you don't like it, go in and change. You can't really hear it as much. Or factory. Grind out some factory or something. I think usually if it's raining on one if it's raining at like 3 a.m. or if it's raining at 3 p.m., it shouldn't be raining at 3 a.m. So maybe just swap which time you go into your raids are. Yeah. You just kind of get used to being completely deaf. Not being able to hear a thing. What's your favorite map at the moment? Yeah, sniper's quite fun. You just have to be really patient. Yeah, I do like this as well. Yeah, nice M700 is the best for something. M62s, watch them fly. Stuff is good fun. Yeah, it's a really hit and miss. Yeah. You have to get them right off the start, otherwise you just have no chance. Really tough, especially when you've got all the sweaty chads running around with meta gear. It's, yeah. If you mean if you shoot a board in heaven, try and get to the bridge where I spawn if you spawn on the custom side. And you, oh no, they've changed the spawns, haven't they? Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, that's rough. Yeah, you... At this point in the wipe, it is quite hard to get into. Especially with, like, the... Go here and kill people with certain gear. It can be quite hard. If you play at the start, the wipe it's a hell of a lot easier. Except for everyone's on the same level. I mean, if you get a Bitcoin farm going, just try and work towards that. And that's just just free money, which means you can buy the better gear. Yeah. Oh. don't think Wipe's going to be for another couple of months yet, realistically. It happened right before Christmas. 23rd or 24th of December, so... Maybe May, June time, it's going to wipe. Yeah. I think that's what a lot of people are doing. By now, people are kind of leaving, and they'll come back when it does wipe. There's not a lot of other games out at the moment, which is my problem. So I thought I'd try this. Yeah, exactly. I think once kind of COVID's over, there'll be a hell of a lot of games released because everybody's been working through COVID, but they've just not been able to release the game yet, I think. So next year's going to probably be a really good year for gaming. But we've got to get there first. And hopefully with, there's supposed to be two expansions within the next year on this game, on Tarkov, so later on in the year I think it's probably going to be a really good time to get back into it when it wipes. New maps, new guns, and new guns in there. But new maps would be cool. Yeah, got Factory, I think it's Lighthouse, and then Streets of Tarkov, if and when they release that. Factory Boss. Yeah. First wipe's always the roughest, but then you kind of get your head around the game and start to enjoy it more, I think. Yeah, I can show you where we're at. Not much going on there. So this is our hideout. Slowly getting there. Got vents upgrading and nutrition upgrading today. So quite a bit of progress. I think this waits on vents, yeah. And then we've just got a ton of rigs. Jungle box is super hard. Because you need the blue fuels, which are now quite rare, I think. Got a couple of pistols for some pistol runs. Okay. Yeah, I think you get some as a quest reward for something. But I can't remember what it is. I don't need that. Keep that. I think I found one so far. Yeah, I think that was a quest reward as well. So it's just... either you get the stuff to craft them, or you just... suffer, I guess. So this should get handed in. You can craft them, but it's a lot of stuff from memory. I think it's 10 of each, which I'm nowhere near. Yeah. And you need six of them, don't you? Ten of each, yeah. And just that space alone is just so much. That's ten, so 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. So this whole space would need to be full of crickets and zibbos until I found them all. It's just a nightmare. Space on this regular account is really bad. That is all you get. Need some more ammo. Oh, have you? Yeah, is rough. Fair play for sticking with it on the regular account, to be fair. It is really difficult. I didn't realise how little room you get. Yeah, I think if you're going to upgrade, I wouldn't recommend getting anything other than EOD. Because I think that the amount that you actually save when you start playing on that slightly upgraded account is just not worth it. But you just need to make sure you get the hours out of the game. If you're going to buy it and then drop it, it's not worth upgrading. If you're going to get the hours out of the game and go for Kappa, definitely worth. Yeah. It's really bad. I mean, once you get to level 10 and you kind of get some money rolling, it's not too bad, I guess, if you're playing on a normal account. But it's just that initial first few raids can be rough if you're stacking up gear. I'm not going to use that. containers can be quite expensive. Obviously, the main one you want is a scav junk box, I think, and mag cases. Yeah, a stash upgrade's not cheap, is it? So I think it's 3.5 mil, 8.5 mil, and then something like €50,000, which is 22 mil. You just really need to get the Bitcoin up and running as soon as you can, I think. Yeah. It is rough. So I've only been able to get this ammo case, which is only 100k. Oh, 200k. Some of the barters are worth it. So the 100 dog tags for a scav junk box, if you can get that, is worth it. Ammo case was worth it. I don't know if it is anymore. It just depends how much you can play. How it can be. Yeah. A lot of the time, questing and just getting those levels up, and getting the quest rewards, you just make a lot of money from doing those. Like the gunsmith ones, if you can do all the gunsmith, I think you get like 5 bitcoins from them, which is it 3 mil? That's a good way to make money. Yeah, just farming computers, doing a scav run whenever you can. So I got my Bitcoin farm within, I think, a week of wipe. For a bit on scavs, but yeah. They are really worth it, even if you just get the gear set that they've got on out. It's just easy 100, 200k. It's just easy money. Yeah. I think that's the way to play. Maybe you joined I think you joined at a pretty good time. Because if you do kill a Chad, you get, like, great gear. Yeah, if you're just running, like, your good gear, good ammo and stuff, just have fun. If you're having fun doing that, it's more than fine. But if you're not, then maybe switch it up. Just go pistol runs or something. See what suits you. It's hard when you want to have fun, use good gear, spend money, and also want to save up and get more space to have more gear. Yeah. What's your favourite? You talking to sniper, right? Bolt actions or like SR-25s, M4s and stuff? Depends on map. Okay. Yeah, this case is solid. Nice. Fair enough. Yeah. Okay. Maybe try it with a semi-auto rifle, like an SR-25 or even a full auto like M4. So that when you, if you get, like, if you get engaged at close range, you've got an answer for it as well. Because you can still stick a Valde or a Voodoo. Voodoo's really good. Stick that on it and go for some snipes, because you can get one or two off really quickly rather than having to cock the bolt back. Yeah, it's a really good gun. I think this one is, it might be the best semi-auto now since the ergonomics rework. It's really nice. Sounds really nice as well, suppressed. But you do have to mod it, which is quite expensive. It's the only problem. And if you don't have M61s or 62s unlocked, you might struggle. I quite like the MDR is quite good for it as well, because you literally put the sight on it and it's good to go. Yeah. if you've got your thick weapons case, you're fine. But if not, I'll just use them. You get to the end of the wipe and you'll have all these guns that you wouldn't have used, that you know you'd have killed people for. So yeah, I'll just use them, dude. Yeah. Fair enough. Yeah. Sometimes questing can get a bit stale. If you're just constantly questing, it's can get a bit rough. So even just switching out for a week and just being like, I'm just gonna take in whatever guns I get and use them for PvP or whatever you fancy doing, and then go back to questing, you might feel like in a better space to do so. Even just buy like a thermal and just go mess around. That's quite fun sometimes. Jesus. One to four, man. I got two thumbs. Fair play. Holy shit. honest. Yeah, the 366 AP can be absolutely devastating. Jeez. I can never seem to snipe well on reserve. I either go up to the observatory and just die. What am I limping for? Not... Oh. Ah, oh, damn it. Where were you sniping them from? It's always tricky because you want to try and find people, but you don't want to get counter sniped. Yeah. I'm dead here. Oh, nice. Yeah, I like the Red Rebel Astronauts. It's annoying that they took out the Woods one. You should be able to use it on Woods as well. I'm not sure if there's... It's very situational, I think, but yeah, it's nice. Where'd you find it? Yeah, it's not worth buying on the flea. Is it in his box or on him? Yeah, I always feel like when I kill Sherman, it's by complete accident. Or I just get super lucky. I've never seen one on him, personally. Yeah. I I don't know how much they're at the moment, but I think I sold one at 4 mil in the first week of wipe. You just saw him like, ooh, that looks cool. Yeah, that is really lucky. Very slim percent chance you actually get that. Yep. I forgot meds. I just need a win. I guess we're going with this. That has been the story of the past 2 hours. Keep that in that. I don't know where to go, to be honest. Wouldn't mind a USB drive, that'd be cool. Oh, right, okay. That's a cool little objective. Get like the axe, the hunter's axe. God, what is that? Are you trying to find them? Find them on scavs and stuff, or? Yeah, I know what you mean. That's a cool objective. Something different. Yeah. I like that. Oh, energy. Oh, the cultist knife, yeah. They're pretty cool. I don't think I've ever really killed them. I've been killed by them. When they take the swing at you, and it's just like, what? Yeah, I know what you mean. Yeah. Hundred percent. And then you kill them, you're like, thank God that's over. Where did you find them on them? Oh shit, really? Yeah, they have really good loot on them. You get like defenders, twos, hex grids. I didn't know they had hex grids. That might be something I need to do on here. Customs. I don't think I've ever run into them there. I've definitely seen them, like clips of them there. Imagine. Right, okay. Imagine you run into Rashala and the cultists. That'd be rough. There's no way you're coming out of there alive. Did he die? Just clap from all sides. That's funny. Yeah, absolutely no chance. It's just the swing of the knife is just so scary. That's funny. That's why I don't go customs. That's why I'm not going customs. Excuse me. Yeah, it's because they know they can get PvP at dorms. Because everyone goes to the marked room, so it's just guaranteed PvP, and they can stomp on little newbies. It's just easy for them. They know the map. Yeah. Because everyone has quests on customs, they know that the lobby is going to be populated. Yep. Interchange is quite similar as well. Not quite to the extent. But yeah. It's either really fat mega chads and killer, or pistol runners just putting graphics cards in their ass. If you can't get inside early, it's just so rough as well. Best way to kind of learn it is just scav run there and just run the route that you would normally take. And just run it as a scav. That's how I kind of got to learn the map. Oh, I need that. anything today. Yeah, I've never really sniped inside Interchange. I only generally go for the quests and loot runs, but yeah, I guess it depends. If you can get inside, it's really quite fun. You can hold the long angles and stuff and watch Kiba and Techlight, I imagine. Yeah, I imagine it is a challenge. There's not an awful lot of angles you can watch. Yeah, it's just something to mix up, I guess, right? Killed all the bosses. That's the challenge. You need to do it for the quest, but that's yeah. If you... Oh, okay. Yeah, I think a lot of people find him because he has pretty good gear. It's that Alton's. The 6B43 armor, the really big armor. You just have to rush him. It's one of those ones where if you get a really bad spawn, there's just no way you're going to be able to kill him. He's one where you have to rush as well, otherwise he's just dead. Can't remember who did a video, but there's loads of videos out there on like how to speedrun killer. Yeah. If he sees you before you shoot him, you're dead. There's very little chance you're going to survive that. You are just dead. goal is, the trick is M61s and an MDR or a hunter. I prefer the MDR, but a bit more expensive. And you just gotta try and get him from behind. Yep. You get an SJ6. How do you get the bullet out of the chamber? Yeah, you just run in with a SJ6 stim, you get like so much stamina, and you just run at him and try and kill him as fast as possible. I think it's 2 to the head, or maybe 3 or 4 to the chest. But I think it'll 0 out the armor if you hit the chest, and that sells for quite a bit. So if you can, go for the head. Don't want to hit him in his face shield, because his face shield is class 6. But the helmet is 4 or 5, I think. So if you hit him in the helmet, you'll kill him quicker than in the eyes. His face. Oh, PSP2. I don't think that's a good one, actually. I think it's okay. Jacket. Give me a rig, come on. Gun is that? It's not pistol. AK? Let's see if I can go kill him, I think. I reckon I hit that first shot. I think because it was a two-round, it bounced off his helmet. Thanks, boys. Oh, they're shooting something. What the fuck? Okay. He saw me. Sorry. I had no idea he was shooting at me. Heels, please. I dropped my mag. Bit of room now. What's that? 36. We die to virtually anything. So the chest here. Search jackets. Good news for me. No, they didn't loot this at all. What? Unless they closed it out for each other. So $10. Was that shot or was that the safe closing? I think that was a scarf. That got scary. Take everything. No, heal chest, heal thorax. That's a bit of a dub. I thought he took it to the head too. Apparently it was the chest. That's 7 and 39 as well. I wonder if I hit those other guys. Hit count 5. How many did I shoot? I think I hit 4. One, miss, headshot. 2. So hit them for, hit 3 shots on those other guys, I think. Oh well. We've got backpack, spare rig, spare gun, 2 guns. Some 8.5mm buckshot, which is always nice. And a couple of euros. Sell. Sell. Peacekeeper. Alright, so I need those wires, need the nails, and that. That goes in here. Couple of pistols. almost don't want to take this because I only have one mag. I might take this instead. Alright, so I'll keep it for now. I'll do that. Right. Yeah, true. I needed that. I needed something. Backpack is good. I don't know what that is. I'll keep that key. Very true. I'm going to take that. Last time I died to a light bleed. Maybe I should take this as well. Still need a cord, but what can you do? Take that as well. A little bit of spare. I'm gonna keep going shoreline, I think. Just stash run. The most comfortable shoreline, so might as well. Can we capitalize? still need the shotgun for Gunsmith Part 1 as well, which has been a pain in the ass. The pistol grip. Loading times, Tarkov loading times. Yeah, I mean, it's 11:35 on a Tuesday morning here, so there's not a lot of people populating the servers. Spawn. We'll just take everything and stuff that we don't need to sell. Oh. Okay, that's an already cash. They're absolutely useless. Nice. So the way that I'm doing this, it's stuff at the top up here I'm going to keep. Chuck. I guess I'll keep that. So that step is, I believe, when a scav spawns in, or when scavs spawn in. Anywhere on the map. There's a barter. I can't remember what the barter is. That key gives you something. Go back and loot all these buildings. I guess we do. Might as well. This is all just crap. It's gonna worth a little bit of money, but I think this is 4 jackets in here. Oh shit. Thanks for hanging out, dude. 6 a.m. with Christ. Yeah, have a good night. Sleep, I guess. Catch you later. Thanks for hanging out. See ya. Check the road for a scan. What the hell, man? Did I even hit him? I don't know how that first one didn't hit him. Holy shit. I hit him 3 times for 153. Okay. T has that much penetration. I'm going to call it there. 3 hours. Not bad. We've got 2 things upgraded. Yeah. I mean, we lost a lot of guns, but we made some progress. Got a couple of kills on woods. Shit. I should have just tried to kill him. I can't believe that. I have that key already, don't I? Yep. I've got a 2-4 key. Oh, that's annoying. Maybe we do this factory and then see what happens. We'll do this. We'll do go factory. See if we can get a look. Oh, no. Okay. We'll do this. And then that'll be it. For today. I'll try and split this into two and then stick it up on YouTube. Yeah, so it happens. Yeah. Hopefully we can get some form of gear out of this. looking for. Scav didn't push me. Fine. No, that would have been a nice kill. I thought it was in the hole in the wall. I think I had a bit of frame drop, dropped a few frames. Kind of just want to go with this. All right, that'll be for next time. Some good progress. I might hop on later and install these items. I might hop on and do some more later, maybe a little bit, one or two raids. See how we go. What is this? Meds. Alright. So we need a motor for that, but we need Jaeger 2 as well. This we need Mechanic 2. And a few other bits, but for Mechanic 2 we need the pistol grip for the shotgun. Yeah. Nice one. Shout out to PJ. And we'll see you later.